My name is Dr. Ishwar Gilada. I am infectious disease expert and I am Secretary General of OMAG, Organized Medicine Academic Guild and People's Health Organization India. We have been discussing on several aspects and several subjects of COVID-19. There are two most important developments which happened in last 2 days. One of them is a survey of Tata Institute of Fundamental Research along with Niti Aayog, Government of India. The survey has been done in Mumbai slums and non-slum population in 6,936 people, where they have tested IgG antibodies in those people. And what they found, that in slum population, almost 57% people have been infected. And in non-slum population, 17% of them were infected. That means they had IgG antibodies that shows past infection to COVID. Similarly, these kind of surveys are also done in Delhi and Ahmedabad. What is common in these three cities? Delhi, Ahmedabad and Mumbai, in non-slum population, average 20% people have IgG antibodies, that means they were infected. When the infection reaches to around 50 to 60%, that is supposed to be called herd immunity. Now, herd immunity can be achieved by two ways. One is through vaccines, and vaccines are a little bit away from us now. When the vaccine comes, we can achieve through that, or through past infection. So, if we look at slum population, they have already reached the herd immunity. And when such kind of infections come, very high rate, we have two questions in mind. One is whether the lockdown has been effective, 4 months lockdown. And it has been seen that despite 4 months lockdown, the infection reached to almost 57% in that population. That means the lockdown had no effect or no impact on that infection. Second thing is whether it is good or bad to have such kind of high infections. Either way, it's bad. People should not have been infected. They should have been following SMS, that is social distancing, mask and sanitization, but that has not happened. So, but it's a good thing is that they are reaching herd immunity, so that remaining 40%, 30% people will be saved. Now, by these two ways, we have to achieve that herd immunity. Till that time, we must save our people. So, currently, death rate which was there in Mumbai around 5.4%, 4 months back, 3 months back, it has been brought down to 3.4%. And national death rate currently is 2.3%. So, if we have been able to push down the death rate below 1%, half battle is won. And remaining, we can see. I would like to now explain what is herd immunity from Wikipedia. It says that it is also called herd effect, community immunity, population immunity or social immunity. It is a form of an indirect protection from infectious disease that occurs when a large percentage of population has become immune to an infection, whether through vaccination or previous infections, thereby providing a measure of protection for individuals who are not immune. In a population in which a large population or individuals possess immunity, such people being unlikely to contribute to disease transmission, chains of infection are more likely to be disrupted, which either stops or shows the spread of disease. The greater the proportion of immune individuals in the community, the smaller the possibility that non-immune individuals will come into contact with an infectious individual, helping to shield non-immune individuals from infection. And we have seen similar kind of immunity through vaccination in polio, smallpox, MMR, that is measles, rubella, etc., mumps. And in that, all the population was, they were given vaccination, but the remaining population which did not receive vaccination, they got herd immunity. So whether we get herd immunity through infection or through vaccine, whichever is better, we should get it and wait for it. Till that time, we should try and protect our elderly people, comorbid people, and bring down the death rate to less than 1%.